Improv on the stage with Norm Macdonald. How's it going?
How's it going? Good.
Very good. Thanks for coming this morning.
You're welcome. I always like to get up 14, 15 hours before a show. Give me a chance to brush my teeth.
You look great, by the way. Well, yeah. I like the style.
As I was at an AM morning show, and I was like, hey, thanks for dressing up. Like, it's 4 in the morning. I'm the odd one for not having a tie on. Everyone else is sleeping other than you.
Well, how you been?
You thought I was the odd duck for not wearing a tie and suit at 4 in the morning. But, have I been?
Uh-huh.
Good, thank you. In front of the Tempe Improv?
Yes, at 9 in the morning. So, you do your jokes depending on your personal experience, stuff like that. What's going on lately?
What? Nothing's happening.
Nothing's happening?
No,
nothing at all?
Nothing.
What?
Well, I mean, things are happening, but they're sort of things that have already happened. As you age, as you'll learn, how old are you? 39? 22? What are you, 26?
40.
How old are you? 26 or 28, right?
Sure.
So as you age, you'll realize something happens, and then later on something happens, you go, hey, that was a lot like that other thing. So the first time you're all excited about it, it's like, yeah, it's all right, but it's sort of like that first one. And then as you go on, everything becomes that. So that's why old guys are never impressed by anything. You go, look, you got a touchdown. They're like, yeah. I remember Bart Starr.
That's the face.
What?
You got the face.
Yeah, that's what the old guys. You're never going to impress an old guy. If there's a 90-year-old guy in the room, he's never going to go, what?
I know.
What was that over there? He's never going to get excited.
So what, you're going to talk about nothing exciting tonight, or just...
Exciting?
Well, I mean, good jokes and stuff.
Yeah, well, so, you know, you're probably not going to be excited. I don't think I'll excite anyone.
All right,
I don't want to promise to excite people and then later, you know, they go, I demand.
Thank you.
What?
No, thank you for that.
I demand remuneration. Because I was told that I would receive some sort of thrill, some rush of excitement. And I did, quite frankly.
You're not a guy. I appreciate it.
Well, you can't promise anything.
That's true.
Can you?
No. Well, okay, let's talk about the talk shows you've been on. You've been a lot, and you're always really funny on those and everything. Have you ever thought of becoming a host? Why not?
Because I'm not very curious about people. I'm very interested.
But you are always curious on
the shows. I admire that you're interested. But like if I had to do it, like one time they wanted me to do a talk show and they said, do you think of any guests? So I was thinking three guys in the whole world. And I'm like, I don't know if I can do this every night. Because as soon as I got an actress, my only question go, what were you in again? You look sort of familiar. I went in and she'd go, I was in this thing. And I go, oh yeah. So you're pretty lucky. I don't know what I'd ask them.
But why? You're always really curious about the other guests on the shows. I mean, curious
about them? No, I'm just, they keep me out there. Conan sticks me on the couch like he won't let me leave. So they come to a three shot and people are talking, so I feel I have to talk.
I mean, they love having you
there.
Why don't
they marry me if they love me so
much? I don't know.
What about you, man? You like you like performing at the Tempe Improv?
No, I don't.
No, you
like
don't.
It.
This is not a club you like performing.
I don't perform anywhere.
You never do stand-up?
No. I don't think I'm funny enough. I don't know what, I mean, it takes a lot, obviously.
I would say you should try even people that aren't ever going to be comedians, just to go on amateur night and try. It's fun.
Maybe I will.
People do karaoke and
will
stuff.
Will you go with me one time?
No. What do you mean, go on stage with you?
No, not on stage with me, but, you know, moral support.
I don't know. I probably
thank you.
I mean, no. I mean, if circumstances were perfect, like if you're doing it tomorrow night, I was here.
All right.
But I'm not going to fly in.
Well, what if I go to L.A.? God,
I guess.
Okay, let's
depends on what I'm doing that night. What if I'm meeting a fish or something with a guy. I said, I would eat fish with you tonight, I say to a guy. And later I'm like, oh, that, what? Yeah, I think I remember something about her saying something.
Food?
No, I would go out with this. Depending on my plans of fish.
You like fish?
Who doesn't like fish?
I don't know.
What, are you
it's not my favorite.
Are you vegetarian?
No, I'm not. I like meat.
That kind of
vegetarian. That kind of. You're terrible. Okay.
What do you eat? Steak?
Yes.
Do you eat pork? Do you eat what?
Okay.
Do you eat shoulder pork? I'm just asking. Have you ever had a pulled pork sandwich?
Yes. I think they're delicious.
Yeah. Who doesn't like pork?
No. I mean, anyway, so the
are
weekend.
Are you wrapping it up?
No. I want to talk about the weekend update. I mean, it was a long time ago, but you were one of my favorites, really, ever. So if you were to do it right now, what were you talking about? Like, give us a fake news right now. Do it.
That sounds hard.
Just something. What were you talking about?
I don't know. It sounds hard. You guys made a make up a joke.
No. Talk about something about the news.
No, but you want me to do it in a funny way, like make a joke.
No.
You just want me to talk about the
news. Do it
news.
In a norm kind of way.
But, well, what's going on in the news? I don't really follow the news. Then how could you react to what I said? How could you go, oh, that was good, because you don't follow the news?
Well, maybe people are going to watch this.
Yeah, but if you don't know, you go, ah, I guess. You would have no idea.
Well, how do you know? Well, I don't know.
You just said you don't know
but
anything about the
just,
news.
Okay.
You're being sarcastic?
I don't.
What's the big news
everything.
Story for you? In Arizona, as a young Hispanic girl.
I'm not sure.
Jesus Christ. It's not a Miss America question. You're a Hispanic girl.
I know, I get that. We're not going to talk, because I didn't bring my papers. We're not going to talk about that.
Well, you bring your papers.
Wait, you are an immigrant too, right?
Yes, I'm also. I'm here on a green card.
Did you bring it?
I got it.
That's good, because they're probably going to ask for it. You kind of look brownish.
Yeah, I'm going to ask for it. And casinos in front of me asking my green card. Whenever you show a green card as a form of ID rather than a passport, they say green card. They don't like
green
it.
Crown.
Yeah, they don't like it. So
I know about it.
I can understand the play.
When I get a green card, I will know about it.
Yeah.
Okay, now we have the questions from Facebook.
Yeah.
Are you born? No,
I'm not born.
Okay. Mark Anderson says, what does it feel like being the best roaster in the world? And then he says, you effing.
Grocer. Well, if you want to know the secret, you start with basil.
Uh-huh.
And you got to slow roast. Look, roast is slow roast. Like when people say roast to me, mm-hmm. I say slow roast. Like I don't even really use a term.
What are you roasting usually?
Turkey. But a lot of times pork, that's why I was asking about shoulder of pork. If you roast a shoulder of pork, you marinate it. Maybe I'm telling tales out of school. But if you marinate it, it falls off the fork.
That's a great story. Alright, no,
okay. Thanks, you're a regular Johnny Carson. You used to say that a lot. That's a great story. Can I make that face?
I think that we're talking about Bob Saget.
Yeah, Bob Saget. Oh, the roasting from Bob Saget?
Yeah.
Well, that was fun too. Yeah, it's fun to make fun of people. I don't really. I like making fun of people.
Yeah.
Will
you ever want to get a roasting
around? Get roasted?
Yeah.
No, I would never want anyone. I say if you're going to make fun of me, do it behind my back.
That's the way.
So I never hear about it. And if you're going to say anything mean about me, I respect the guys that do it behind my back. But there's some guys that go, hey, at least I say it to your face. I'm honest. I don't care about your honesty. I'd rather you were more deceitful and behind my back said these things and then I didn't know.
That's a good point. I like it. Okay.
Just me.
Jason Molina says, do you have any new stories about Bob Uecker?
Adam. He does, he told me that he had a heart attack when he had a heart attack. Just think about having a heart attack is the first thing. You get embarrassed. They came here with a stretcher. They wanted to take me out of my back. And I said, I got papers, man. I'll go up 45 degrees. That's what we decided. That's a tough old man.
Yeah.
Like if you or I had a heart attack.
When was our it?
His first instinct, embarrassment, our first instinct would be terror for our lives.
Yes.
So he's old time. He had neighbors. He
didn't. That's crazy. When was this?
I don't know. Well, are you the girl that asked the question that has nothing to do with the story?
No,
and
yeah.
The story ends and then you're like, what year was it? The punchline, I just said it. No, I forgot the year. Wait a minute. 1944. That's the end? No, you said it.
I thought it was more recent. But... So, how the hell are you?
Good. How are you?
Okay, I'm good.
You like your...
I like it here. It's a little hot, but, you know.
It was very hot last night.
Can't complain. Gonna go to the casino?
It was, you know how I feel? It's very hot. Plus, I can't. Go to the casino with the Chiefs. Play
that sounds like a great
game. Give me good poker stories. I heard something about rounders being based on.
I was in a character was supposed to be based on.
I've seen it.
Oh.
Which character?
I don't think it's true.
Which one?
But I did know Garrett was definitely from, played with me for a while. And the John Turturro character was, he played a guy named Joey Donuts in the movie or something. He was Joey Bagels in real life. He would drive me to the club. His story was more interesting than the one in the movie. The movie that was out of the But the reason he was called Joey Bagels is because he they still drove a bagel truck, so he picked me up in a bagel truck. We had bagels in the bag, it was empty. Because we're still talking about bagels, this was before school, but okay. So he would drive to the bagel truck.
Yeah, I've seen a lot of pictures of you
about
celebrity poker thing. Thank you.